How long is your house gonna last? If you live in a single family home, how long before it starts to rot and fall over?
If exposed to water and air on a cycle, wood will not last very long. And most houses in the United States are made out of wood.
If you keep the wood dry, it can obviously last a lot longer. But what's the limit?
I'm getting set up to build a small cottage here on the glorious vertically oriented bedrock of the Silurian Ordovician Vasselboro Formation here in central Maine. And we know that stone walls can last a long, long time because so many of them have. You can see ruins all over the place. But you only see the ones that lasted, and obviously, most buildings that were built out of stone did not last. So what is the limiting factor gonna be in how long this cottage can last? Now, if I get the mix design right, these stone walls will last for 1,000 years before eventually thermal and frost cycling starts to jack them apart and they fall over. But that's not what's gonna limit the lifespan of that cottage. In fact, that's not what limits the lifespan of most buildings. This is. Ow, my hands. Jesus Christ. Ah, that's so hot. This is. See, we can build stone walls, and it doesn't matter if they get wet, because they'll dry right out again, and that's not gonna harm the mortar any. But until very recently, there was no way to build a roof that would last as long as a stone wall. Modern buildings, single family homes, you're looking at a really good lifespan, maybe 70 years. That's with good moisture barriers, a good roof, well installed, all the I's dotted and T's crossed. This building is about 45 years old, and you might think, this roof looks great, and it does, because it is not the original roof. It's so hot up here, I am dripping. If you want to make a building to last for 1,000 years, you're pretty much gonna have to agree with yourself that it's going to need roof work. I have to get down off of here, I'm melting. That'll work, that'll play. Ah. Oh. Used to be, if you wanted a roof that would last forever, you had basically one option, slate tiles. Now, if you were building a castle and there was no slate anywhere around, way too expensive to import, you could fire ceramic tiles and they would last a pretty long time too. The problem is, they're not quite as strong. But over a really long lifespan, slate roofs are only as good as the membrane underneath them because eventually they will let water in. If you look at these asphalt tiles, they've conformed and made a nice mat so that they're not gonna let any water in. Yes, there's a membrane underneath them, but these tiles are doing a great job keeping out water, for now. Slate's not gonna do that, obviously. So no matter how good you build your building, you're going to have to replace the roof. This is why so many medieval castle ruins are just a box with no roof. Dude, the sweat is dripping into my mouth. When those roof timbers rotted away, eventually, nobody wanted to live there and nobody bothered to replace them. If you want a building to last for 1,000 years and still have a roof over the head of your great-grandchildren's great-great-grandchildren or whatever, you're going to have to replace the roof. So, sitting here in the wreckage of this once glorious sheep barn, and I'm asking myself, how am I gonna design a building to last as long as possible? What are the materials that I'm actually gonna use? I'll tell you some details. First of all, I am not going to use a mortar that is too hard. If the mortar is too hard, especially if it's harder than the rocks that it's surrounding, which again, are sedimentary, incompletely metamorphosed rocks, mostly from the Silurian Ordovician Vasselboro Formation, look it up. If I use a mortar that's too hard, it's actually gonna crack the rocks. It's not gonna knock the wall down, but eventually water's gonna get into those cracks, freeze, jack the rocks apart, and knock my wall over. So I need to use a soft mortar with a relatively high percentage of lime in it. That's gonna need to be repointed in about 100 years, but we'll talk about that in a moment. What am I gonna use for the roof? Now, for cost reasons, I don't think that I'm gonna go with anything pressure treated. I think that I'm gonna work on making a really good membrane and putting it over some timbers that I cut right out of the woods. This roof is probably going to be a Galvalume. If I can find something better, if I can find some slate tiles that I can use, if a miracle happens and I luck into something like that, that's great and that's exactly what I'll do. But I'm probably gonna use Galvalume, which is a mix of a ton of aluminum in an alloy with steel. It's a very, very stainless steel. It's one of the most popular options for a really long-lasting roof. It's that painted corrugated metal look. In terms of a foundation, sometimes the foundation fails of a building, and that introduces inconsistencies in the structure, which let in water, which cause rot, which destroy the building. As we saw, my building is gonna be built right on bedrock. I'm gonna have to do some really careful prep to make sure that the mortar gets a really good bond with that underlying bedrock. But as was pointed out in the article that I'll link down below, the most important way to make sure that your building lasts for 1,000 years is to make sure that people still care about it. And that you can kind of control. You can go for a timeless style, as the article says, but really that's kind of out of your control. You can really only make a building last for as long as you're willing to keep fixing it. I feel like that's kind of a really bad conclusion to this video, but it's true, I think, anyway. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe if you want to see more videos like this, and I'll see you in the next one.